Darryl, time for another rodeo. I mean, obviously, you guys kind of mixing and matching last week on the offensive line. How do you think the guys held up?
I think we did pretty good. I mean, we got our run game back going, but we still little things we got to tweak. But other than that, I feel like we had a pretty good game plan going into that game.
How hungry are you guys to get off this losing streak?
Oh, we're very hungry. I mean, we got to get a win. I mean, we need it. That's something that we've been preaching. We got to get this win. We got to get off this losing streak that we've been on. So,
as a captain, what do you kind of say to guys, or what did you maybe say to some the offensive line or whoever about, you know, what you guys need to do next, or what's kind of the mood?
Just keep going. I mean, keep pushing. I mean, soon there's something going to crack. I mean, that's all we can do is just keep pushing at this point of the season. So, then that's all I've been preaching to those guys. Just keep pushing.
Missing Stu and Island last week, how difficult was that for you in the middle there to keep communication and keep guys on the same page?
I mean, it was a little difficult, but I'm sure. But like I said, Coach Johnny does an excellent job of getting guys ready for the playing those big time games and big time spots when guys go down. So I think LaQuince and Michael Stewart did a great job going into that game.
Seemed like when LaQuince went in, things kind of settled down for you. And he's a first year player. What's your impressions of him? How's he played for you guys?
Oh man, LaQuince, he's been playing pretty good ball. I mean, knowing he came from JUCO, now he's expected to play big time ball now in the SEC play. So I'm just thankful for him. I think Coach Johnny did his job getting him prepared and getting him ready.
With all the frustrations of the season, this club has had a lot of success against Arkansas home and away. Is that kind of a confidence edge going to this rematch?
We're taking it one game at a time. I mean, that's something that we got to do. I mean, Arkansas, like they said, like I heard, Arkansas are good. I mean, they've been on a losing streak too. So I'm thinking they're hungry for a win. Mm-hmm. So we just got to know what our heads head on straight and be able to prepare for that game.
They have some veterans on that front too. What has kind of been your impressions of what you've seen from them on film?
Like I said, I studied on Sunday. I studied those guys. I studied Tim McGee, number three. I studied Feeder two. I studied those guys. I studied their tendency. So I see how they go into each and every game, how they play. So I'm looking forward to that challenge. Can't see how the game plays out.
Colin was saying that y'all have kind of focused on it's about the individual. You want to be out there, and it's about wanting to be on the field and fighting every week. Is that something that you've seen kind of preach this week?
Most definitely. I think start of Sunday, Coach Mohair asked us right down our why we play football, why are we here, why do we want to be here, what makes us drive each and every day. So I think that was a great thing that Coach Mohair did Sunday, make us write a letter to say what's our why.
What was your why?
All my wives, I love this game. I mean, this is something I grew up as a kid growing up loving this game as a football player. So I'm just continuing to go out and do my best each and every play.
We talked to Garrett and some other guys about the offensive struggles in the first quarters of games, whether SEC or not. What would it mean to actually get out there and get a fast start for a change?
Oh, it would be huge. I mean, that's something that we've been preaching on this week. I mean, we got to start fast on offense. I mean, to get our defense a chance to not being on the plus side on the defense side of the field. So I think we got to start fast this game to get the, hopefully to swing the momentum to our side. And we're looking forward to that.
You guys went up there 2 years ago, and it seemed like it was a nightmare kind of getting started. You had the muff punt, then fumbling end zone there. How difficult is it when you get in a hole in the road like that to come back?
I mean, it's very difficult. That's something that we preach. We can't get in the hole against these guys. I mean, we got to stay the course, and we got to be able to instead of getting in 3rd and 10, we got to be able to be in 3rd and 4 and 3rd and 3, not being in 3rd and 6. They got a lot of exotic business, some of the John Chavis has done over the years. So, look, we got to stay in front of the chains.
You mentioned the starting fast. Is there anything you see maybe over the last couple of weeks that you'd like attribute to the slow starts, or is there anything that's been consistent, do you think, or is it?
I mean, we gotta make sure our run game starts fast. I mean, I think it started slow the first two drives we got, but then as we got settled down, I think the run game started picking up. So I think we gotta start fast in our run game.
Coach Moorhead's talking about it a little bit. Do you feel like this offense kind of it gets going when the run game gets going?
Most definitely. I mean, it does get going once the run game goes, because, I mean, they make defenders come up and then we get to hit our deep shots over the top. So we got to get our run game going.
It's a complicated issue, and it's in its infant stages, but the NCAA today said that they would support players getting paid to play. What are your general thoughts on that?
I mean, I seen it, but I haven't had any thoughts on it. I'm preparing for Arkansas and getting ready for those guys. But, I mean, I'm sure guys probably love it, but right now I'm just not focused on it. I'm focused on getting our second SEC win.